Here we are at the first dig of 2015. We found this neat old dump here. Lots of broken stuff. This is disappointing. It's a liquid stove polish. It's just got that one piece out of it. And I found this cool little cork top right there. Nothing on it. There's broken stuff. But my dad, there's a green bottle. Might not be anything. We're gonna pull it out and see. Nah, just a green crown top. We'll keep looking.
All right, we got three bottles here and probably broken, but we'll take a look. Where's one?
I see a hole.
Serto or something?
What is that?
A funny line at the side.
That's probably a Serto.
At the bottom of the property, the foundation was kind of right there where that pile of snow is.
I just found this. Looks like this is the well. Let's take a look. I don't know. Very likely could have been. It's the only building left here. It's a neat find. We're gonna keep on looking. Well, at this point, we're basically risking our lives to dig these bottles on the edge of this extremely steep bank. They're all just kind of fetched up here. And I guess we might have something. Father says right in here that survived. Everything's broken. It's a lot of old stuff, but... Oh my gosh. It's whole. It's whole. It is whole. Oh, that's a nerveline. We needed one of those because we only have the ones with the embossing on the sides. That is nice. Aqua blue, nerveline prepared by the, oh boy, Catarozone Co., Kingston, Ontario. That just made the day right there. It's about time. We've been digging for over 2 hours, and this is pretty much the first good find we've got. Catch up with you later. Just came across this awesome looking old vehicle here in the woods. I wonder what this was. Definitely old. Wow. And in a more modern dump over there, I just found a really good condition orange crush cream soda can. I'm gonna keep that. We're gonna keep on looking. Oh, my dad just found a milk bottle filled with red stuff for some reason. We find a lot of them like that. I don't know what it is. There it is. It's just a blank full quart. Still pretty good. All right, here we are the next day. We're at a new site, and I just found this. Looks like there's two insulators. Oh yeah. Nice. There could be more in this pool too, actually. We're gonna get it out and show you when they're off. Here's the two insulators we got. They both have the wooden pegs still attached to them. They are number 40, Hemingray. Nice, two of them there. And we got one more right there.
Ooh, it's broken.
It's broken? No, it is broken. How badly broken, though? It's broken in half, isn't it? That one's not in great shape. That one, oh, that's a Brookfield. That's a different one, though. I might keep it anyway. All right, we're gonna keep looking. All right, this is the last dump we were at for a little while. We've done some digging. I got this good old Atlas Easy Seal Mason jar. There's a bunch of them here, but this is the oldest one. There's some air bubbles in it. We got a thick glass Coke and just some other odds and ends here in this old tobacco tin. And my dad just found this. Little doorknob. So we got a 1 liter. Oh, nice. Look at that. That should clean up pretty good.
Different one we got?
I'm not sure. Yeah, we'll take it anyway. All right, we'll show you everything all cleaned up at the end. Here we are again at the same dump we were at last week. We've got permission to search this place with the landowner, and there's the old house. It's all empty and everything. But it was built in 1944, and it's been vacant for about, around 20, 30 years. So it's been empty for quite a while. So hopefully we can find some nice old 40s, 50s, maybe some pop bottles, and we'll catch up when we do. All right, we've been digging here for a while, and my dad just pulled this out. First good find so far. We got a Dominion clear glass insulator. Very nice. Hopefully we'll find some more. All right, we just got our second insulator. This is a Armstrong. A little bit different. It's got a couple chips in the back. But that'll still look nice. We're gonna keep on looking. Digging that same pouch. This just popped out. It's a neat little one. It's kind of hard to read here. It says a Bromo Seltzer right there. But I've found these before, but we never actually kept any, so I'm gonna keep this one. That's pretty neat. We're gonna keep on looking. We're actually pouring a lot of good stuff out of that little spot. Ah, that would have been nice. Here's what my father just pulled out. It's probably hard to read in the lighting, but it says scientific compounds. There's like two crests there, and they get the same over here. Screw top, you can tell by the bottom that it's fairly old. So we're gonna take that. Keep on looking. Get a couple salt and pepper shakers. They match each other, they're pretty close to each other too. Pretty cool, we're gonna keep looking. Finally, after it must be 45 minutes, we found a good bottle. It is a nice mint condition Swirl Pepsi paint label bottle. Pepsi Cola there, Pepsi around here. Hopefully it's gonna clean up really well. Hopefully we'll find some more, we're gonna keep on looking. All right, so out of there, I just pulled out this nice orange crush can. My dad said he's found the greatest thing so far.
Brown.
Nice. Oh shoot, the paint's coming off.
What's the paint?
Wow. That is awesome. Look at that. Hopefully that'll clean up. There's already paint missing there, but hopefully that'll look really good. Check under like old decks of houses. Sometimes people drop things. And that is the case because there's a dinky car right down there. See if we can get it out. There it is. It's a neat little one. Date in the bottom. Hot Wheels Mercedes 540K 1982.
82?
Yep. That's pretty neat. We're all done for today. So thank you for watching. We'll show you everything all cleaned up at the very end.